The munificence of America to Ireland in her distress is beyond example. Her frigates being the bearers of her bounty, her glory is the greater. When a ship of war created for the mission of death is made the messenger of life, it presents one of the noble characteristics of the enlightened days we live in, at which humanity may rejoice. Samuel Lover, 1847.
Sweet land of song, thy harp doth hang upon the willows now. While famine's blight and fever's pang stab misery on thy brow, yet take thy harp and raise thy voice, though faint and low it be, and let thy sinking heart rejoice in friends still left to thee. Look out, across the sea that girds thy emerald shore. A ship of war is bound for thee, but with no warlike store. Her thunder steeps its mercy's breath that waves her o'er the sea. She goes not forth to deal out death, but bears new life to thee. Thy wasted hand can scarcely strike the chords of grateful praise. Thy plaintive tone is now unlike the voice of prouder days. Yet in her sorrow tuneful still, let Erin's voice proclaim in bardic praise on every hill Columbia's glorious name.